गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सो मोशन अंडर ग्रेविटी क्विक रिवीजन। इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड काइनेमेटिक इक्वेशंस, फ्रीली फॉलिंग बॉडी, वर्टिकली प्रोजेक्टेड बॉडी एंड वर्टिकली प्रोजेक्टेड बॉडी फ्रॉम टॉप ऑफ ए टर्न, ऑल थिंग्स विच वी हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड। बट फॉर कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स हाउ वी कैन रिमेंबर दिस फॉर क्विक रिविजन, सो दैट विच आई एम गोइंग टू टेल बेस्ड ऑन दिस काइनेमेटिक इक्वेशंस, सो विच वी नो वेरी वेल। So three equations, which is nothing but V is equals to U plus A T. Second one is S is equals to U T plus half A T square. And third one is V square minus U square equals to 2 A S. These three equations already which you have been proved. So freely falling body. Whenever you have been taken an object, that object which it will falls freely. If this is a ground, if I have been taken this as an object, if it falls means that is a freely falling body. So in this case, I am not applying any kind of velocity. U is equals to zero. So that object which it will travels in downwards in direction. So acceleration already you have been discussed. Towards at, which is nothing but a positive, A is equals to plus g, and this is the displacement which I can take here as a s with the help of this equations. So initial velocity is equals to zero. With the help of this, I can get here as v equals to g t, and with the help of this, s is equals to initial velocity is zero. So half g t square. So with the help of this, which I can get here as, so u value is zero. So v square equals to, which I can get here as 2 g s. In some cases, if you have to find out the final velocity with the help of this equation, so we can take here as v is equals to root of 2 g s. So with the help of this, which we can be fine. Wherever you have been taken vertically projected body, in case of vertically projected body, which it should have to move from point of projection to maximum height. In this case, here I have been taken this as an object. If it reaches to maximum height, so here it will be having some initial velocity. And then here it will be having some final velocity. That final velocity is nothing but v is equals to zero. When we are taking this s, which is equals to h maximum. Otherwise, in between you have been taken, it will be having some value. So with the help of this, the kinematic equations which you can write here as. So and what about its acceleration? So object is moving upwards, that is opposite to that of acceleration due to gravity. So with the help of this, from first equation, 0 is equals to u minus g t, and second equation, so which is nothing but we can take maximum h maximum, or we can substitute s also. So s is equals to, so u t minus half g t square. So in the same way, here final velocity will be zero. So minus u square, which is equals to minus 2 g s. So minus minus gets cancelled. With the help of this, yes, we can write here as u square by 2 g. So this equation we can write here as, which is nothing but h maximum is nothing but, so u square by 2 g. So this equation which we are using so many cases. From this equation, so which I can get here as, so u equals to g t, that's which is nothing but t equals to u by g, the time taken by a body to reach maximum height. So that's which is nothing but t a is equals to u by g. So with the help of this equation, if it reaches maximum, means here S is nothing but H maximum. With the help of this equation, I can write here as, so U square by 2G, which is equals to half G T D square, time of descent. The help of this, if you solve this, means TD is equals to, we can get here as U by G, already which we have been proved. So with the help of this, time of flight T is nothing but TA plus TD, the time taken by a body which it will use in air from point of projection to reach 1 second, that's which is nothing but U by G plus U by G. That's T is equals to, I can write here as 2U by G. These all are the equations which we can be used while solving the numericals. And third case, vertically projected body from top of a tower. Here I should have to take like this, from top of a tower, which I can take, this is a tower. If this is an object, if it moves upwards and then if it comes, so this will be the H, and upwards we can take it as a positive and downwards we can take it as a negative. So with the help of this, again same we can use here, what is it, so regarding acceleration, means acceleration is nothing but A is equals to minus G. So this initial velocity will be U, and whenever if it touches this point, this velocity will be the V. If you have to find mid velocity also, it will, we can take it as a V with the help of this. So V is equals to U minus G T. Second one, S is equals to minus H, displacement. So overall you have been taken, this will be the plus X, this will be the minus X, will get cancelled. And minus H, minus H is equals to, so UT minus half G T square, that which I can take here as, which is nothing but, so minus H is equals to, I am writing once again, UT minus half G T square. With the help of this, multiplying with respect to minus, H is equals to, I can get here as half G T square minus UT. And finally, this equation you can write here as half G T square minus UT minus H is equals to 0. This is in the form of AX square plus BX plus C equals to 0. By using this equation, by quadratic equation, by formula, we can find out the time period. And regarding, if you are coming for this part, so we can take here as, for freely falling body, so what are the simple graphs? For freely falling body, you have been taken that distance, position with respect to time, which will be increases. So with the help of this, which I can write here as, that's, so displacement time graph. So from this point, as if I have been taken, so it will be, goes on, increases. So in uniform acceleration. So with the help of this, we can get here as like this. So if you have been taken for this, we have been taken a plotted a graph between velocity and time. So velocity and time, so how will be equal change in velocity in equal intervals of time? That's here, velocity also will remains constant. Here theta will be the constant. So and finally, acceleration, whenever it is falling freely, in such a case, so uniform acceleration, while doing all these, we have been set it as a uniform acceleration, because G value will be remains constant. That how much plus G, which is nothing but, so 9.8 meter per second square. So in the same way, for vertically projected body you have been taken here x, or you can take s also, no problem, with the help of s. So here what it will happen, this object will move upwards and then it will come down. First it will be at the bottom, then it will reaches maximum, then again it will comes to this point. So time taken by a body to reach maximum height, which is nothing but u by g, to reach the same point, which I can take here as 2u by g. So next you have been taken. So what about its velocity? So velocity which you have been taken here as like this. So here velocity time we have been taken. Here we should have to apply some velocity, then object will reaches, and then its velocity will become zero, then again it will comes down. That means velocity will be the negative. So it will comes to this point. First it will be maximum, then it will comes decreases, it will be there. If I am considering, if this is the initial value u, and this will be the same but opposite. So and then finally third one, which I can take here as, so acceleration time graph. Acceleration time graph we have been taken here. Sorry, I am taking here. This is the time. Here acceleration is nothing but a is equals to minus g, because while moving upwards for vertically projected body, a value will be the minus g. So this is these three equations for freely falling body and these three equations for vertically projected body. Students, please subscribe my channel and share to your friends, and then like. Thank you.